It definitely does feel good, and I feel satisfied that all the effort has paid off. So yeah, it feels great.
We're very, very happy, extremely happy that he's got these scores. It's not very common for a kid to get these kind of high scores, and he's consistently done well in all these exams. And it's been a tremendous amount of work that he's put in to get there. So also it's like a lot of satisfaction that the hard work has paid off.
So it's always a pleasure when your students are scoring very high, and especially when you see them, reach to their potential. It's always heartening and great.
Initially, a few years back, I knew I had to do well and I had to get into a great college, but I didn't have a clear idea of how well I should do. So, and it was during the last few months that I crystallized on a score and a rank that I must aim for.
See, Arjun's always been a good student in school, but in school everybody typically does well, right? Everybody gets a 10 CGPA or a 95% kind of a thing. So we knew that he's a good student, he has the talent to do well, but honestly we were not so sure that he'll get this high marks or this high rank. We knew that he's going to get one of the good rank, but no, we were definitely not very sure and very clear that he'll get this high rank.
Well, I was fortunate enough to meet him. In fact, when I first met him, I realized that he has potential and he will definitely get a rank if he's targeted towards that. The only thing that I felt was that he is not exposed to the problem sets to get those ranks. And all I have to do is plan and structure in such a way that he gets that rank. But definitely had a potential when I saw him first.
So I want to pure science and I was very interested in physics. So I thought I'll write KVPY and get a great rank in that. So in the first 1.5 years, I decided that I prepare for KVPY on my own because the coaching institute didn't have dedicated courses for KVPY. So I started preparing on my own and I bought all the books and study material which is required for the exam, and I studied on my own. And whenever I would have any questions, I would look up for some resources online and do this kind of study on my own till the time that I came across Vedantu.
See, as Arjun was very clear that he wanted to, or from a long time, from 9th, 10th standard also, he had this goal that he wants to study physics. So. And if you want to study pure sciences, you've got to be in one of the best institutes. So for us, the choice of institutes was also limited. It has to be maybe the IISc, one of the IITs kind of a thing. So that was how we began the journey really. And yes, today KVPY is one of the important exams where you can get admission into IIT. So that's what we kept in focus in the beginning. But and obviously JEE Advanced is also an important exam because that also leads you into entry into these institutes. So that was also one of the goals that we had. So he began the journey by thinking that he will start with KVPY, but progressed to saying that we have to crack the JEE exam also.
So initially, as I said before, I was preparing on my own and I was looking up, I was learning the concepts required for KVPY, no, because they were not taught at school through different reference material and stuff. So after KVPY didn't go so well and I couldn't clear it, and I realized that then I required some coaching for GE so that I can do much better, and I had to learn some concepts which usually people do teach in coaching institutes which are required for JEE. I came across Vedantu's masterclass program, and my father showed this to me, and I immediately the first masterclass program was Anand Sir and Pulkit Sir teaching specific topics required for JEE. So I thought I'll try that out and see what I can learn. and I liked it a lot. And they taught in a very well manner. After that, I saw that they had a JEE Crash Course also. So I thought that I should sign up for that, and it'll help me revise my concepts for JEE. And so that's how I signed up for this.
For us, the key thing was that he has to get a good rank, right? And Arjun, Arjun decided actually more than us that he will prepare on his own. And preparing on his own, you know, you can take it up to a point. We also waited for some time. We said we gave him time and space for him to prepare on his own. So really the turning point came when his scores were not catching up to that level, okay? So that's when I think when we chanced upon this masterclass, I said, okay, why don't we at least try it? And it was online, okay? And the other thing that really attracted us was the teachers. Here were some of the best teachers who had actually produced some of the topmost ranks in IIT exam, and they were doing this master. So I told them that why don't you just take the master class and see what you gain. And the experience was very good. So he really felt that the classes helped him. I was also apprehensive because he was by the time he had already finished 1.5 years of preparation. So I was not sure whether he might turn around and say, yeah, it was okay, I will not learn something. But he was very happy when he attended those master classes. He said, yeah, I think there is an extra bit there, and I'm learning something extra. The other thing, so to me, I think more than online, I think the important thing is that you have to learn from a teacher who is really good and a teacher who has taught rankers, right? See, if you're a great maths physics teacher, but you've never prepared for IIT exam, students for IIT exam, you cannot prepare because this is a highly competitive exam. You know, so the best students are preparing and they're being coached by the best teachers, and some of the teachers have been preparing. So that combination in this course of the best teachers are teaching and they have produced ranks before, that is what attracted us. But obviously online has a huge benefit, right? Arjun could spend time at home, at his comfort, and we didn't have to travel, especially living in Bangalore and traveling such a big thing. This was a big advantage. He could really juggle between his preparation and time for things. So many days I used to see him like he's preparing for his own, then immediately the class time starts. He just has to switch on the computer and start this class. He doesn't have to travel anywhere, have to go anywhere. And so it was actually a very good experience. So to me, online is just a medium. Okay, the essence of it is the great teachers and the method behind it. See, when we joined the course, I think, so first we took the master class, and then we came and met Anand. And I think the first big thing was talking to Anand, and Anand reassuring us that, you know, I think this, your son has potential. Because we can keep hoping about our kid, and Arjun can keep dreaming about his rank. But somebody who's taught other children, giving that reassurance that I think your son has potential and he'll do well, is really, was really reassuring, and we really felt nice about it. So then very clearly, my expectation was his rank will definitely improve. His rank, whatever his score he's trying to get now, and will definitely improve. More importantly, the surety of him getting that will be there. That is what we were clearly expecting from that course.
So while preparing for KVPY, KVPY happened in November, and since the school had not completed the portions for 12, I had to rush through them myself. And I managed to do that just a few weeks before KVPY. And so I felt that preparation was not up to the mark for KVPY, and that I had not gone into the depth of each topic. So after that, after I joined the crash course, I learned a lot from that, and I really liked the way it was taught, and I felt much more confident about it. And then we started with the part tests, and I did good in the first few part tests, and that's when Anand Sir contacted me. I met Anand Sir, and then he told me that we should aim for a great rank and we should aim for a good score. And he made a detailed plan about how we should go about it. And so that gave me the confidence that I can actually do it. And so with that, we start off with the part tests in the beginning, and we did the part tests at a much faster pace than it was being given out at the crash course. And we were doing a part test every other day. And then in the full tests, we set a benchmark for a score and we worked towards that. And we had thought of a score of around 300. And I was able to do that in those tests. And soon in the JEE Mains also, my score was around that range.
I think the turning point to me was, I think we were meeting Anand, and Anand said that, I remember he said that he is a top 500 or top 300, something he said. Okay, and that coming from somebody who's an experienced teacher, without Anand had seen some of his scores, marks and all that, but I don't think, because he's also looking at other children, I don't think it's such a, but he said, I think he has potential to be top some 500 or something, top 500, he said. I think that day we knew that, you know, he'll do well. It is, I felt personally. And I remember going back in the car with Anand, with Arjun, and telling him that, well, see, he's so sure and he knows it, he knows the game, he knows how to coach students. So you should really listen to whatever he says and you should prepare, you know, on the path that he will take. So that, I think, to me personally was the turning point.
See, one other thing is the experience that I have of the past 12 years. I have taught and mentored more than 20,000 kids. And in that journey, I have realized that it's the kid and their parents. They have to balance each other during the preparation time. And whenever I talk to a student about a potential rank, I also talk to the parents that how much involved they are. So there is always a fine balance between a push for the preparation and fine balance between keeping an eye on the student. And that's what I see both from the student as well as the parent. So when I first called Arjun to Vedantu, I met his father also, and I realized that time that he has a potential, huge potential. And at the same time, his father had that, you know, fine balance wherein he can also support and keep an eye and not be very pushy. And that's when I decided that he can definitely get to a rank which I was intending. And from there, we, as Arjun said, that we had a detailed plan of exactly how his test would be and what the rank should he be targeting. So from there on, the journey was very simple.
So after JEE Main, Anand sir told me that for the first 20 days, we should focus on doing a lot of questions which are at the level in which they ask questions in JEE Advanced. So we did a lot of modules which had, each module had around 60 questions. I was doing these modules at pace of one a day initially, and then in the end I did 3 to 4 a day. So these modules also had many topics, some closely related topics. Each module had like 2 or 3 closely related topics. And so that was also a big advantage, because usually the material which you find outside, you'll have each topic will have one whole book, which is not what you should be doing the last when you have 40 days left. So these actually helped me revise and also solve many good problems, which gave me a lot of confidence for JEE Advanced. And then after that, in the last 15 to 20 days, we did a lot of tests. So we did a 6-hour test every alternate day. And the next day we would analyze these tests and work on the area, weak areas, and whatever I got wrong in the previous day's test. And during the last week, we did a test every day.
See, when I met him, I knew that he had potential. But one thing I was sure that he was not exposed to very high level problems, and that is what required to get into this top 500 rank in JEE. So the only thing that I had to do was plan one thing at a time. So he just came out of KVPY, and then the other target was JEE Mains. So first thing that we did was from November till March, we will only focus on JEE Main and will not focus on JEE Advanced, because he had not been preparing for JEE Advanced for the past 2 years. Mm-hmm. So we did that, and we strategized with a lot of tests and the pace of the test. We changed the pace of the test and varied that. So initially there was a 1 week gap, and then we paced it every alternate day. But the moment, the day he gave JEE Mains, from the sec- from that day onwards only, we had a plan of exposing him to highest level problems. And that's where our expertise come, that we have designed the modules in such a way that it contains questions which are not independently from that topic, but it is interrelated. And it takes the student from a very, you know, basic level to the highest level in very short span of time. So in these 20 days, I planned that you should be exposed to these questions. And then post that, obviously, tests are extremely important to gain that confidence and also to, you know, sharpen those skills. And generally, we have designed these tests in such a way that the percentages that you will get in these tests, your percentage in advance, whatever type of paper they ask you, your average percentage will remain the same.
Mm-hmm.
So his average score here was around 67-68%, and that's what he got in JEE Advanced also. So that was the whole strategy of exposing him to the highest level problem.
My, as I said, my initial goal was to clear KVPY, but that didn't happen. And I realized that in order to get a good college, I'll have to do really well in JEE Mains and Advanced. So I immediately switched my goal to JEE, and I realized that there's no point worrying about what went wrong in KVPY. Instead, I take all my learnings and then forget about what happened in the past, and then look towards doing well in JEE. So my parents were very supportive, and they didn't. They also were not very concerned that I didn't do well in KVPY. They said that you can definitely do well in JEE, and they also said that even if you don't do well, there are a lot of other options available. You can always probably even drop a year if it doesn't happen at the end. So, and of course, when I met Anand Sir, that was when I was really sure that I can do well, because he gave me that sort of confidence and reassurance. I'd say what everyone else has to say. It's the mantra that's been working. So you'll have to work hard, and you'll have to also be consistent and be true to yourself, and don't give up no matter what happens.